something we take for granted every day. That's walking 3 feet, turning on the faucet, and getting as much clean water as we want. This doesn't happen as easily all over the world. 783 million people do not have access to clean and safe water worldwide. Exposure to unsafe drinking water, inadequate sanitation, and poor hygiene is the leading cause of cholera and a variety of other infectious tropical diseases in the African region. Over half of the developing world's primary schools don't have access to water and sanitation facilities.
Oh. A need for clean water doesn't just affect drinking and bathing, but it causes a shortage of food. Sub-Saharan Africa is dry, and without water, the crops won't grow. This causes many young boys and girls to not only be dehydrated from lack of clean drinking water, but malnourished from a lack of proper nutrients and vitamins from food.
Girls around the world like me should be able to get an education, but many parts of Africa are dropping out of school due to the water crisis. 72% of the water carried to homes is hauled by women and girls. The average container for water collected in Africa, the jerry can, weighs over 40 pounds when full. The United Nations estimate that sub-Saharan Africa alone loses 40 billion hours per year collecting water, the same as the entire year's labor in all of France.
Sometimes people will walk for miles to a river to get water and then find that it isn't even clean. A lot of sewage pipes are dumped into the river. Agencies like the Water Project team are digging wells and placing play pumps in some locations of Africa that need clean water. We recently visited our local wastewater treatment plant to find out how hard it would be to clean this type of water and how a play pump might work.
Our local wastewater treatment plant cleans water from over 80 miles. The water comes from hospitals, restaurants, prisons, school systems, and homes. This plant processes over a million gallons a day.
According to the World Health Organization, for every $1 invested in the water and sanitation, there is an economic return of between $3 and $34. For our robotics research, we have joined the Water Project effort to raise awareness, to raise the money to change the clean water shortage in Africa. Please check out our Facebook page or Twitter page for a link in our donation site. Every dime counts. Thanks for helping the Wildcat Wayfarers make a difference today.